Hi, and welcome to another episode of The Barefoot Deacon. Today I want to talk to you about something that resonated with a few people from a recent sermon that I did. And it's a quote that I bought a plaque with this quote on it many, many years ago. And the quote is this: "Don't ask what the world needs. Ask what makes you come alive and go do it. Because what the world needs is people who have come alive." That's a quote by Howard Thurman, and it has lived on my bathroom wall for many, many years. And when I first bought this little decorative plaque, the reason I bought it is because I was living in survival mode. I really didn't feel like I was thriving at all. I was just surviving. I was just kind of getting through my days, going through the motions, but really not feeling very alive at all. Someone once said to me that your life should be about 80% things you want to do and 20% things you have to do. And when I heard that, I took a look at my life and I realized that 90% of my life was things I had to do, not really things I wanted to do. And that's probably why I was pretty depressed, not feeling very alive. So I started to shift that, just a little at a time. And you don't have to take huge steps. If you've ever noticed, like if you get on a ship that's headed across the ocean and you change the compass pointing just a little bit, you end up on a totally different continent. So minor shifts can make major changes in your life. So what I did was I started to think about things I wanted to do, things that made me come alive. And I started to shift more of my attention to those things. And I kind of went back to the concept of tithing. You know, we say that it's best to give the first 10% of your income to nonprofits or church or the things that you care about in the world, but to share that first 10%. And I started to think about the things I gave my attention to. And I started giving my attention, the first 10% of my attention, to things that made me feel alive and made me feel excited and gave me energy instead of draining my energy. And once you make a shift like that, it can completely change how you go through your day. So now I would say there's a lot more of the things I do are because I want to, not because I have to. Now, there's always things that we're going to do that are maybe not our favorite things, but even changing our attitude about them can make a difference. So recently, I was doing some things that I literally hate doing. I was on the phone with insurance companies. I was trying to get an installation done at my house. Things were just not going according to plan, and I was working really hard at fixing a lot of problems that I didn't want to have. And in my head, I said, I hate this so much. And then I said, nope, that is not the energy that I want to give to this situation. That is not going to solve any problems. So I literally said to myself, I love having the opportunity to solve these issues. And I didn't even get that thought completed in my head. And my phone rang with somebody who was solving one of the problems that I was having. A shift in attention, a shift in your energy, of movement towards the things that make you feel most alive can create a pattern of living your life fully alive. Jesus said that he came here so that we would have life and have it abundantly. I don't think he said so that we could have abundant stress. That is not what he said. But have life abundant. Fully alive is what Jesus intended for us. So I hope you'll take some time to think about how much of your day is doing things you want to, things that make you feel alive, things that give you energy, and how much of it is things that drain your energy and pull you away from your true purpose. Sometimes just shifting your focus can be the compass change that will take you to an entirely different place in your life. A better place, more life, more abundant. I hope you will take some time to do the things that help you feel fully and completely alive, because the world really does need more people who have come alive. Thank you for joining us. I hope to see you again next time.